In this video, I am going to explain muscles and fascia that attach to occiput. Occiput is part of head. It's part of cranium. This is very important place. Why? Because upper cervical spines and occiput should be treated as one unit. This complex is very important as functionally and mechanically. Thus, muscles attaching this place are equally important, correct? Let me explain muscles from deep layer. I'm gonna explain from tiny muscles. Let's look at this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Oh my gosh, that's so long name. Rectus capitis posterior minor. Next one is this one. This is rectus capitis posterior major. Rectus capitis posterior major. One more tiny muscle. That's here. This is obliquus capitis superior. These three muscles are suboccipital muscles. Actually, there are four muscles, but the other one doesn't attach to occiput. That attaches to C1 and C2. This is obliquus capitis inferior. That sounds weird, doesn't it? This pink one represents obliquus capitis inferior. You know, capitis represents occiput. But this pink one, pink muscle doesn't attach to occiput, but its name is obliquus capitis inferior. It's a little bit confusing, but that's how it is. Anyway, rectus capitis posterior minor, major, obliquus capitis superior. Last one from this picture, that's this one. This is longus capitis. Longus capitis. You might have noticed when muscle has name that has capitis that attaches to occiput, except obliquus capitis inferior, right? Capitis represents occiput. Name of muscles is hard to memorize at first part, but if you know taxonomy, it's easy to memorize name of muscles. Let's go to next picture. Okay, this is middle layer. I'm gonna explain two muscles and one fascia. Let's go to fascia. This is it. This is fascia on the superficial part of skull. This is galea aponeurotica. Galea aponeurotica. This attaches to occiput and it goes to parietal part. Okay, how about this one? This is semispinalis capitis. Semispinalis capitis. Again, its name has capitis. No doubt this muscle attaches to occiput. Next muscle also has capitis. This is it. This is splenius capitis. See, memorizing muscle makes easy if you learn taxonomy. Capitis implies occiput. Easy. So, galea aponeurotica. Semispinalis capitis. And splenius capitis. This is like middle layer of back of neck. Let's go to the most superficial part. This is superficial layer. You see galea aponeurotica for two parts. Let's go to first muscle from this picture. That's this one. This is famous muscle. This is trapezius. Trapezius, it attaches to occiput. Next one is this one. This is sternocleidomastoid. Sternocleidomastoid. Wait a minute. Sternocleidomastoid attaches to mastoid process, doesn't it? Mastoid process is on temporal bone. Yes, that is true. However, if you look anatomy book carefully, that says sternocleidomastoid attaches to occiput. This is very important thing. So technically, the name of muscle should be sternocleidomastoid occipitalis or something like that. Some anatomy books don't say it attaches to occiput, but other books, some books say it attaches to occiput. By the way, space between trapezius and sternocleidomastoid is important. This represents nerve. This is greater occipital nerve. This nerve is very important for pain sensation on back of head and parietal part. If trapezius or sternocleidomastoid gets tight, that may create impingement for greater occipital nerve. Then what's going to happen? You may have headache around occipital area. See, you have seen many muscles that attach to occiput. No wonder too much tension around this area can lead to headache, neck pain, and so many head issues. Does it make sense? These muscles are on posterior part of occiput. Then other muscles and fascia actually attach to anterior part of occiput. Let's look at them. Okay, this is profile view. This part, left part of temporal bone is removed. This is occiput, this is C1, C2. This part is posterior part. Many muscles attaching occiput. We just look at them, right? This is posterior part. This is anterior part. You see two muscles. Let's see this one, this tiny one. This is rectus capitis anterior. Rectus capitis anterior. Capitis, that represents head, right? So, of course, this muscle attached to occiput. How about this one? Name of this muscle is longus capitis, of course. Longus capitis. These muscles are in front of cervical spines. You can say these two muscles can affect visceral part of cervical area, such as throat, esophagus, and trachea. No wonder these muscles have relationship with visceral portion, right? Speaking of visceral portion, occiput has attachment of fascia. It's like this. It's hard to describe. There is myofascial attachment on base of skull. Of course, it attaches to occiput. The name of fascia is pharyngobasilar fascia. Pharyngobasilar fascia. Pharyngo means pharynx, that is about throat area. Basilar, base, it's the base of skull. So it connects throat and base of skull, fascia. This is very important myofascial connection to visceral part of cervical area. It's very important. Anyway, rectus capitis anterior, longus capitis, and pharyngobasilar fascia. As I said, occiput, C1 and C2 should be treated as one unit. They are mechanically, anatomically important place. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.